and welcome to the Exponential Smoothing tutorial series. In our last few tutorials, we discussed how to construct one or multiple steps out of a sample forecast and the calibration process for the smoothing parameters for Holt-Winters double exponential smoothing. Now, we'll demonstrate how to calculate a fitted or in-sample forecast and its components, level and trend. For the data, we're going to be using the weekly volume demand data of a hypothetical product. First, select the cell E10. And then type in the double exponential function name, equals DESMTH, open parentheses. Once you find the function, click on the FX button found on the left side of the equation toolbar. This will invoke the function arguments dialog box for the double exponential function. For the input data, select the cell range corresponding to the whole demand volume sample data, which is C10 to C103. And then lock the cells by pressing F4. For the time order in the input data, type in true or 1 to designate the first observation as the earliest observation. For the level smoothing parameter alpha, you can type in a value or reference an existing cell. In this example, we'll reference the value in D1. And then lock the cell by pressing F4. For the trend smoothing parameter beta, you can type in a value or reference an existing cell. In this example, let's reference the value in D2. And then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For the optimization switch, leave it disabled by referencing the D3 cell. And then lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For forecast time, type in or select a cell with a value of the number of steps past the end of the data to include, and then lock the cell by pressing F4. For the return type, type in 3 for one step in sample level component series, and then click OK. The function returns the first value in the array. To display the whole array, select the cell starting with E10 and all the rows below it. Press F2 to edit the formula, and then press Control, Shift, and then Enter. The selected cells are now populated with the array values, and the formula is surrounded by italic braces. Let's do the same for the trend component. To make it easier this time, let's copy the formula from E10. So select the E10 cell, and then copy the cell to F10. Now we can edit the formula in F10, and then change the return type. So select F10, and then click on the FX button found on the left side of the equation toolbar. The function arguments dialog box for the double exponential function will pop up. Leave all arguments intact and go to the return type field and change the value from 3 to 4 for trend component, and then click OK. The function returns the first value in the trend component array. To display the whole array, select the cell starting with F10 and all the rows below it, and then press F2 to edit the formula. Hold down Control, Shift, and Enter, and then the selected cells will be populated with the array values, and the formula is surrounded by italic braces. We'll repeat the same procedure for the in-sample forecast component, so select the cell F10 and copy it to the cell G10. Select the G10 cell and then click the FX button. In the function arguments dialog box, change the return type value from 4 to 5, and then click OK. The function returns the first value in the forecast component array. To display the whole array, select the cell starting with G10 and all the rows below it. Then press F2 to edit the formula. Hold down Control and Shift, then hit Enter. The selected cells are now populated with the array values, and the formula is surrounded by italic braces. Finally, let's plot the level and trend components. Since the level and trend have different magnitudes, we used a separate axis scale for each, level on the left-hand side and trend on the right-hand side. The trend component values are relatively stable, around -9 per step. That's all for now. Thank you for watching.